So let us start with the topic. First of all, this topic is very, the basics are not clear to most of the people. It is not, it's not even clear in the government policies. You will see the meaning of informal sector in one scheme, this is something else. In another scheme, this is something else. Even the government itself in the economic survey has been discussing this thing, that what is the meaning of actually the informal sector or the informal worker, right? So first of all, this topic is dealing with two areas. One is the informal worker and second is the informal sector, right? So we will discuss both the things simultaneously. So if there is a question on the informal sector, or there is a question on informal sector employment, or there is a question on informal worker, in all these three you can mention the content from this discussion. And plus, it is not that you have to use the entire content as it is, you have to use the relevant content. Okay, so first of all, what is informal worker, right? And before we know what is informal, we should know what is formal, right? So formal worker is that person or that worker who is employed by the organized sector normally. What is the meaning of organized sector? It means the private companies, it means the PSUs and other enterprises whose number of workers are more than 10 in case they are operating through electricity, and in case they are without electricity, then number of workers is more than 20. 20 or more, so not more than 20 or more, right? So this is the meaning of organized sector. So those people who are working in organized sector, plus they have a formal contract of employment. So they are called formal workers. Now, who are informal workers? So those workers who are working in the formal sector or in the organized sector, right? So we have already seen the meaning of formal organized sector in this sector, but they are working on a casual basis. And there is no formal contract. And when I say basically contract, here the contract does not mean contract labor. It basically means, the better word will be the formal agreement of employment, which is like there is some job security. Not that the job security is for lifetime, but like there will be some notice period, 1 month, 3 months, right? And then they are getting some social security, EPFO, retirement benefits, pension, paid leaves, etc. Formal sector, organized sector mein wo work kar rahe hain, but they are either working on a casual basis. What is the meaning of casual? That means daily workers, dihadi mazdoor jinko bolte hain, daily wage laborers, right? Or even if they are working regularly, but they are on ad hoc basis. There is no job security, there is no social benefit which is given to them. Then Second category is those people who are working in the unorganized sector. So this is the broad meaning of formal and informal worker, right? Now let us see. So there are many definitions and different concepts as per, you know, regarding the formality or informality, and this debate or this discussion is as per the economic survey. Ye economic survey ne bola hai. Economic survey has mentioned this thing. Economic survey of 2017-18. That there are many definitions. Some are based upon the contract, the formality or informality of the contract between the worker and the employer. Second, whether worker is a regular salaried as opposed to self-employed or casual. ठीक है, तो again regular salaried means there is a some kind of job security and the social security benefits. Whether a firm is registered with any branch of the government, that is another way of looking at the sector, right? So basically there are two things you should understand. One thing is informal sector. Another is the informal worker. ठीक है, so informal worker we have seen those who are working in the informal sector or those who are working in the formal sector but casual, right? Now what is the meaning of informal sector as such? ठीक है, so I have discussed the meaning of organized sector. Organized sector is something where the number of employees, basically, in fact, I can say informal sector, how to identify, there are multiple criteria. Either we can see whether the firm is paying the tax or not, basically the GST and the GST registration basically. Second is we can see whether the firm is registered for social security laws like in EPFO, ESI. EPFO means Employee Provident Fund Organization, ESI means Employee State Insurance. And third is the size, jo humne bola, the organized versus unorganized. So what is the impact of organized and unorganized? If it is organized, then it has to be registered in various laws, for example Factories Act, etc. If it is unorganized, then there is no statutory obligation. Now coming back, informal sector, it is primarily about the relation between the firm and the government. Informal worker, this is primarily about the relation between the worker and employer. Are you getting? Is it clear to everyone? Informal sector, when we say, it is more about the relation between the firm and the government, whether the firm is registered in the tax law, whether it is registered in the social security law, whether this is registered in various other laws because of the size, the organized, unorganized. ठीक है, when we say informal worker, it is about the relation between the employer and the employee. So in the informal sector there is no defined relation, and in the formal sector again those people who don't have the formal relation, they are called the informal worker. So you should be clear about these two aspects. Is it clear to everyone? Please say yes or no. Anyone having any doubt? because this is something which I like, this is something which I come across, I mean, there are a lot of queries people ask me, sir, what is the difference? Confusion रहता है, economic survey कुछ बोलता है, news में कुछ आता है, है ना, government scheme में कुछ लिखा होता है. So primarily this is the concept. Now, coming back to the economic survey discussion. So these two things are basically talking about the employer and the employee, and these three things they are talking about the firm or the employer and the government. So these are the two broad areas or the two categories in which we categorize the formal informal sector. And economic survey 2017-18, it has analyzed the informality in two ways. The social security, that is the EPFO, ESI, medical benefit, etc. And the firm under the tax net, that is the primarily GST registration. So, अभी हम लोग सिर्फ डिस्कस कर रहे हैं. अभी हम लोगों ने कुछ एनालिसिस नहीं किया है. We are just discussing what is formality, informality, so that your concept become clear about this aspect. Now, this is as per the National Commission for Enterprises in Unorganized Sector classification. ठीक है? So this is a commission which has given its own classification, जो हम लोगों ने first में discuss किया था. That first of all, what is unorganized sector? Unorganized sector consists of all unincorporated. What is the meaning of unincorporated? That means they are not registered as corporate. What is the meaning of corporate? Corporate means the company. So those enterprises which are not registered as the company, owned by the individuals or household, engaged in the sale and production of goods and services, operated on a proprietary or partnership basis. या तो वो individual firm है, proprietorship है या partnership है, and there is and with less than 10 total worker, right? 10 worker का concept है, and assuming that it is being operated by the electrical means. ठीक है, तो without electricity में 20 हो जाएगा, but for our discussion let us stick to this only. Second, the informal worker consists of those working in the unorganized sector, excluding regular worker with social security benefit. Number two, the worker in the formal sector without any employment benefit or social security provided by the employer. ठीक है, formal sector में है लेकिन कोई employment benefit नहीं है, कोई social security नहीं है. ठीक है, a worker in the organized sector includes, now what is the meaning of organized sector? It includes the government departments, a worker working in the organized sector includes the government department, the public enterprises, that is the PSUs, and private establishments which hire 10 or more worker, and plus, so here the condition is plus, and to whom any employment benefit, social security provided by the employer are termed as the formal employment. ठीक है, employment benefit, for example, paid holidays, social security again, for example, the EPFO, right? Now, as per the latest available data on the employment, there has been an increase in the share of formal employment as captured by the regular wage salary from 17.9% in 2011-12 to 22.8% in 2017-18. So there is an increase in the formal sector. There is an increase in the formal employment basically. Now the observation as per the economic survey 17-18. So economic survey 17-18 analyze the data on two parameter. One is the GST registration and second is the registration in the social security initiative. So as per the finding, 87% of the firms are purely informal. Matlab,
they are outside both social security and the tax net.
12% of the firms are under tax but not social security net. Less than 0.1% are in the social security net but not in the tax net. India's formal sector non-farm payroll. Now what is the meaning of non-farm payroll? That means the manufacturing, service and other sector excluding the agriculture. India's formal sector non-farm payroll is substantially greater than currently believed. It is estimated to be ranging from 31% in case of social security defined formality and 53% in case of tax defined formality. ठीक है, तो अभी हमारा जो understand like at that point of time the understanding is that only 10% is the formal employment. In fact, not 10%, 15%. 15% is the formal employment in non-farm payroll. This was the understanding before this survey came. But this survey clarified that as per our estimate, if we go by two criteria, then the formal sector is having more share. ठीक है? So this is the observation of economic survey. Economic survey is a government survey. It is not the authority document. It is not something, I mean, which is, it is not a notification. It is not some commission which is giving the report ki actually mein aisa hai. It is just a survey, right? So this is the observation and we cannot conclude anything based upon this. Theek hai? We can just make a reference to this, we can just, you know, mention the reference, but we cannot conclude anything based upon this. Now what are the features of informal sector? Low level of organization, small in scale, usually employing fewer than 10 worker and often from the immediate family. So normally most of them they are family businesses. Heterogeneity and activity. Heterogeneity means they are like working in all the sectors. You will find them in all the sectors and they can range from the small shop and to, you know, a for example a coaching institute which is not registered as a company or it is not employing sufficient employees, or it can be in the service. I mean ye humne dekha trading mein, ye service sector mein, manufacturing mein, it can be in the rural area. A easier entry and exit, so it is comparatively easier to get the entry. That is one reason why there is high level of informalization. Anyone can start the business. There is no requirement of registration. There is no obligation once the business is started. Usually minimum capital investment is required, little or no division between the labor and the capital. Normally the person who is the owner is also the investor and is also the person who is actually working in the business. Mostly labor intensive work requiring low level skill. ठीक है, तो you can see low level skill. It means most of the people who are in the low skill grade, they are working in this sector because it does not require the high level skill unlike in the service sector. If you go in the service sector, for example, if you go in the IT sector, so it requires the qualification, it requires some technical know-how. But those people who are migrating from rural area, those people who are not able to get the employment in the agriculture sector, they will definitely find this sector very much relevant. Labor relations based on the casual employment or social relationship as a page. Like the social relationship based on that means there is no interview or competition, vacancy, placement, kuch nahi hai. Bhai ka beta hai, दोस्त का जानने वाला है, उसी को एम्प्लॉय की तरह रख लेते हैं. एज अपोज टू द फॉर्मल कॉन्ट्रैक्ट, एम्प्लॉयर एंड एम्प्लॉय रिलेशनशिप इज ऑफन अनरिटन एंड इनफॉर्मल विद नो राइट्स. सो दिस इज द प्रॉब्लम. देर आर नो राइट्स, देर आर नो सोशल सिक्योरिटी, देर इज नो जॉब सिक्योरिटी, देर इज नो वेल डिफाइंड वर्किंग कंडीशन कि आपको ये मिलेगा हमारी तरफ से. देर इज नो टेकिंग लाइक प्रॉमिस दैट यू विल गेट दिस मच मिनिमम वेज, राइट? सो देर इज कंप्लीटली informal, or casual and unwritten relationship. Due to their isolation and invisibility, the workers in the informal sector are often unaware of their rights, cannot organize them. So this is the problem. They cannot organize them means because they don't have the single organization where they can meet. So often they do not make any trade union. They do not make any trade union, right? And have little bargaining power and have little negotiating power with the employer and the intermediaries. So this is the observation of the ILO. ठीक है? Now, some of the special characteristics of the unorganized workers. The unorganized labor are omnipresent, means you will find everywhere. They are suffering from seasonal employment, unstable employment, scattered workplace because they cannot find the work where they live. No formal document and relationship. They are usually subjected to the crime, customs like child marriage, debt, bondage. So bond labor bhi par, bonded labor bhi hoti hai. Exploitation due to poor working condition, low wage, lack of work status. So they don't have any status, work recognition. ठीक है? So suppose you become the engineer in the Infosys, you get some recognition from your family, from your friends, your relatives, but here there is no recognition. Large scale ignorance and illiteracy leads to lack of technology use. So they are not much skilled. Lack of awareness leads to environmental issues due to slum and informal settlement, right? They do not have received any attention from the trade union. Unorganized workers can be categorized in four heads. So these are the type of workers which we are talking about. In terms of occupation, the self-employed, the farmers, the fishermen and the artisans. In terms of the nature of employment, the laborers, migrants. In terms of the especially distressed category, the scavengers, the carriers of head loads, drivers. In terms of service categories, domestic worker, vendors, barber, all these are the informal worker, right? So I hope you are getting a sense ki hum kiski baat kar rahe hain. Now some of the data. Today in the formal sector, the employment is only 10% of the working population, right? As per the periodic labor force survey, 90% of the India's workforce was informally employed. Around 84.7% of the people who are in the unorganized or informal sector according to the NSSO, and this excludes the employment in the field of agriculture. So hum baat kar rahe hain, like if we exclude the agriculture, then 85%. Manufacturing, trade and construction are the main sector. Okay, manufacturing, trade and construction. You will find real estate mein, there is lot of labor. So all of them are the unorganized sector, informal worker. Then the organizations estimate comes and this is basically about the COVID-19, that the people who are working in the informal economy, most of them they were forced migrated, or they started migrating to their home towns or home village, right? And there is no job security, food security for them. So there is a chance, as per the report, that they will be falling deeper into the poverty because of the informalization, because of the COVID-19 pandemic. Then between 2004-05 and 17-18, the share of informal workforce witnessed a decline. So decline to hua hai, theek hai na? But what is more important is that the share of informal worker in the formal sector has increased. Theek hai, so this is something which is worrisome. Ki formal sector mein, in the formal sector, the informal workers are increasing. It means the big companies, it means the public sector undertakings, now they are hiring more informal worker. विच इज अ कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न, ये कॉज ऑफ कंसर्न है, ठीक है। सो यू कैन सी दीस फोर मेजर कैटेगरीज ऑफ इनफॉर्मल वर्कर, होलसेल, रिटेल ट्रेड, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग, ट्रांसपोर्टेशन स्टोरेज, कम्युनिकेशन एंड द कंस्ट्रक्शन, एमएसएमई, यू विल सी लेटर ऑन, यू कैन सी दिस थिंग्स लेटर ऑन। इफ यू सी वर्ल्ड वाइड एवरेज 60% इज द इनफॉर्मल वर्किंग पॉपुलेशन इन द वर्ल्ड लेवल, एंड कंट्री वाइज बांग्लादेश इज वेरी गुड, इट हैज ओनली 48%, श्रीलंका 60%, नेपाल 90%। आई मीन इफ यू सी आवर ऑन नेबरिंग कंट्रीज, इवन देयर शेयर इन द इनफॉर्मल सेक्टर इज लो, दैट मीन्स इंडिया रियली नीड टू थिंक वॉट शुड बी डन। वॉट इज द कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ दिस सेक्टर? इट इज हाइएस्ट जॉब प्रोवाइडर, देन इट इज द बैकबोन ऑफ द इकोनॉमी बिकॉज इट ऑल्सो सपोर्ट्स द फॉर्मल सेक्टर। And it provides the input for the heavy industries, and it also provides the employment to the women, for example, the domestic workers. Now, why so much informalization? ठीक है, informalization इतना क्यों है? So, first of all, we started focusing on the big industries after the second five-year plan. We thought that the development in the heavy industries, basic industries, will percolate down to the low level, and automatically the job will be created, skill will be developed, technology will be penetrated, and the per capita income will increase. But because of the failure of the PSUs, that did not happen, right? Second, we were importing the technology from the outside countries. We were dependent on the technology which was imported from the Western countries. And this imported technology, this was labor saving, because somehow their population is not as high as India, as India's population. So their technologies are mostly labor saving, and because of this, not much jobs can be created in the organized sector or in the formal sector, whether this is the private company or public company, right? Then the industrial policy resolutions of the government of India, they began the process of reservation of manufacture of consumer products of non-durable nature for the small sector. This resulted into the perverse incentive to the remain small. ठीक है, तो there was SSI reservation which we talked about, and because of this policy, these SSIs, they got incentive to remain small, because if they remain small, then they will get some benefit, and because of this, they did not increase their size, which could have provided more employment in the formal sector, right? Then trade union strikes of the 1980s. So in the 1980s, there are high number of trade union strikes, high amount of violence which took place in the cities like Bombay, right? In the cities like even in the Delhi NCR, many cities, for example, there is a small town in district Ghaziabad, Modinagar, that industrial town was like completely stalled. So because of this, the big industries or the big industrialists, they decided that we will minimize the regular employees, because the regular employees, they make the trade unions, and then they organize, and then they create the problem, violence, etc. The market economy after 1991, so what is the meaning of this? So basically, we started liberalization, privatization and globalization reforms. Liberalization, privatization and globalization reforms. So because of this, number one, as there was focus on the privatization, the focus on the profits increased. And for to increase the profit, the focus on the cost reduction, and cost can be reduced by employing more informal labor, because the cost of informal labor is comparatively less than the formal labor. So the big companies, private companies, they started employing more amount of informal laborers. This is the one thing. Secondly, even the government companies, the PSUs, who used to be the model employers and who used to provide the mass employment, they started disinvested. I mean, the disinvestment process started in them, and they wanted to be competitive. And for this competitiveness, they also started reducing the number of jobs so that they can maintain the profit. So in the formal sector, be it the private sector, be it the public sector, in both the sectors, the number of jobs which were created in the formal sector got reduced. Then if we see the social security law, what is the meaning of social security law? Again, for example, EPFO, you know, employee state insurance, or providing the paid holidays or maternity benefit, all these. So their focus was, ek term use karte hain, that is, in 1951 we adopted the socialism model, right, for the country. But this socialism ended for the industry in 1991, but socialism for the worker welfare, socialism in the labor laws, that did not end in 1991. What is the meaning of that? That means there are two kind of people. Abhi agar aap dekhte hain, abhi, now if you see why there is so much demand for the government job, why everyone is looking for ki mujhe kahin naukri mil jaye, chahe clerk ban jao main, theek hai, aap to IAS ki preparation kar rahe ho. Why there is so much demand? Because if you become the government employee, you become entitled to so many benefits. Not only the basic pay, but the allowances plus so many medical benefit to your family, right? Paid holidays, then you know, retirement benefit. Matlab aapki zindagi kat jayegi aaram se, usme to kuch chinta ki baat nahi hai, theek hai? Achhi shaadi ho jayegi, family wale aapko respect se dekhenge. Government job mil gaya to saari tension khatam, theek hai? But if you don't have the government job, then mostly, not for everyone, but there is a struggle, right? So this is happening because in the labor laws there is so much protection given to the worker. Jo formal worker hai, uska itna dhyan rakha gaya hai ki yaar ek bar aapko job mil jaye, once you get the job, then aap tension free ho jao, bas aap job le lo kisi bhi tarah se formal sector mein, uske baad aapko chinta karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Means there is so much focus on the protection of the formal worker. In the process, the cost of compliance or the cost of labor plus the cost of compliance increases very much for the company, and they are not ready to hire the regular worker, the formal worker, right? Rather, they are interested in hiring the informal worker or without any employer, without any contract. So in simple word, we can say over protection of the formal workers in the social security law. Matlab jisko government job mil jaye ya jisko formal job mil jaye, uske liye to sab kuch hai, theek hai? Aur jisko government job na mile, jisko formal sector mein job na mile, uske liye kuch bhi nahi hai. Not even the unemployment allowance, So this differentiation is also one of the reason why there is so much, you know, burden on the formal sector with respect to the number of with respect to the cost of employment for each employee. ठीक है? Then the presence of restrictive labor laws promote the culture of contract hiring and casual hiring. For example, in factory law and in industrial relations law, there are many provisions. For example, if you are employing more than 100 worker, then before shifting your place of business, you have to consult the trade union, you have to inform the government, you have to make so many compliances with the government, you have to provide so many number of holidays to your employees. There is requirement of minimum this level of working condition. You have to invest so much amount in the crèche for the woman. I mean, there are so many obligations that if a person is doing the business, then person says ki yaar theek hai, main chota rahunga to koi problem nahi hai, agar main bada banunga to zyada problem hai. Inspector Raj shuru ho jayega, so many obligations will come, the cost of labor will increase. So better I remain small, and rather than hiring the regular employee, I will hire the casual employee and there will be no obligation, right? So let us quickly review. Number one, the SSI reservation. Number two, the labor saving imported technologies. Number three, the trade union strikes of 1980s. Then market economy after 1991. Then over protection of the formal worker in the social security law. Then presence of the restrictive labor laws. Then service sector. So you must be knowing that we migrated from agriculture directly to the service sector. I have discussed this thing in a separate video. You can see and you will find the proper discussion I have done. And you must go through that video. Matlab must hai aapke liye, right? That is a must video for you, right? So because of this, now our skill development, if we talk about the skill development, our vocational education policies were completely absent. In 1950s only, we started focusing on the IIT. And this IIT, they were good for the higher education. But first of all, they can't accommodate much people. Right? I mean, this was not for masses. This was only for few. And mostly for the urban people, English speaking people. Right? So, we focused on the higher education. But we missed the vocational education. And what is the disadvantage? Because of missing the vocational education, our manufacturing sector could not grow. And this manufacturing sector, this can employ the labor from low or mid-skill segment who are coming from the agriculture sector. So when there is over pressure in the agriculture sector, there is migration to the urban areas. So these people, they don't have skill. They don't have skill. There is forced migration, distress migration. ठीक है? And they are looking for employment where without investing any amount, they can start working. So our growth was focused on the service sector, but the labor was available in the unskilled category. So the service sector, number one, it provides job only to few people. Otherwise also the employment intensity is very, very low. Employment elasticity of this service sector is very, very low. If service sector is creating 10 jobs for the same business, manufacturing sector will create maybe 50 jobs, 60 jobs for the same level of growth, right? So the employment elasticity of the service sector is very, very poor. Lack of focus on the manufacturing, which we have seen that because of this, we missed the manufacturing bus. Then Brahminical mindset, which says that it is better to invest in the capital than the labor intensive industries. Kyo? Aisa kyo tha? Because somehow even the government incentive, they were based on capital investment. that if you make this much of capital investment, the government will provide 30% subsidy, that is called capital subsidy. ठीक है, so इस तरह की subsidy government ने दी. So automatically the focus will be on the capital investment only, and this capital intensive investment is not conducive to the more number of job. So in the formal sector, the more number of job could not be created. And simply see, if there is a lack of job creation, then the people who don't have the job, they will invariably be employed in the informal sector. They have no choice, but they will be employed in the agriculture, in the, you know, laborer, in the construction, real estate, manufacturing. They will become driver, street vendor, domestic worker. मतलब फिर काम ही का दस्ता है, जो मिले वो कर लो. अगर manufacturing sector में job create नहीं, अगर organized sector में job create नहीं होती है, ठीक है. So we are actually looking into कि organized sector में job create क्यों नहीं हो रही है. वो हमारा रीजन, वो हमारा एक पॉइंट है देखने का कि हम लोगों ने ऑर्गेनाइज सेक्टर में जॉब क्रिएट क्यों नहीं की, और इवन व्हाई द कंपनीज दे डोंट कन्वर्ट देमसेल्व्स इनटू ऑर्गेनाइज्ड कंपनीज. दैट इज आवर पर्सपेक्टिव, हम वहां पर फोकस कर रहे हैं, ठीक है ना. नेक्स्ट इज द एग्जिट मैकेनिज्म सच एज आईबीसी, दे वर ऑल्सो एबसेंट. ठीक है, तो वंस एनीवन एंटर्स इनटू द बिजनेस, it is very difficult to get exit, right? So therefore people were not ready to formalize the businesses. Then because of the 2018 crisis also, there were various big companies which had to become small. Theek hai, then Southeast Asian crisis, Eurozone crisis, it has affected India's economy, and the corporate expansion plan, they were reduced. The closure of several industries in the formal sector. ठीक है, and then COVID-19 crisis, again the same thing, the joblessness in the formal sector. ठीक है, तो आप देख सकते हैं, there is so much suffering, there is distress migration, reverse migration basically. Then this is another argument from the economic survey. Economic survey mein, this economic survey of 1819 last year, it focused on the why firms they remain small. Why firms remain small or informal. So there are two terms, the dwarf, this term has been utilized by this survey. The firm with less than 100 worker, and giants, the firm with more than 100 workers. This is a simple definition. ठीक है, so if we see dwarfs, ये dwarf है, employment creation, productivity, the productivity of the giant is very high, the productivity of dwarf is very low, the amount of employment generated in the giant is very high, and the employment created in the dwarf is very law. So dwarf means firms with less than 100 worker, despite being more than 10 years, 10 साल के होने के बाद भी, they account for more than 50% of the organized firm in the manufacturing by number. They contribute only 14% to the employment and only 8% to the productivity, and large firm, they are very much productive, they create large amount of employment. So simply it means that those companies which are dwarf, those firms which are dwarf, that means who are small in size and who are older, they are not growing, they are not creating any employment, they are not productive. So they are threat. We should actually discourage them, and we should focus on the young companies to become big. We should remove all the benefit which are being given to these dwarfs in the form of MSME, because most of them are MSME, वो mostly MSME है. So we should remove all the benefit which are being given to these dwarf. And this is the reasons of unemployment which I have discussed. I hope you are watching my lecture, and you will find this discussion there. आप वहाँ पर इसको मिल जाएगा, ठीक है. From this discussion, we can also mention the infrastructure bottlenecks, because of which we could not create much infrastructure for the formal sector. Saving and investment slowdown, which was mentioned in the economic survey 17-18, and high population growth rate. Okay, these 3 points we can mention from here. Rigid labor law, we can see from here, Factories Act, Industrial Dispute Act, they have been quite restrictive, leading to the informalization. Okay. Now, what is the impact of being informal? Iska impact kya padta hai? Theek hai? Impact primarily on the economy. We are talking about impact on the economy. Number one, their productivity is very, very less. Unki productivity bahut hi kam hoti hai. Theek hai? So, their productivity is very, very low. As we have just seen in the economic survey also, that the productivity of dwarfs is very, very low. The protection offered by different regulations is mostly not complied with in the informal sector. The protection to the employees in the form of medical benefit, in the form of other benefit, which is that is not given. Then, because of the small size, primarily they are operating in the cash, they are not formal, and because they are operating in the cash, there is a lot of black money involved, which leads to the lack of taxation. So there is reduction in the tax revenue, and there is a vicious impact on the growth and development because of this. So small formal sector or large informal sector, leading to the low tax base, leading to the low tax revenue, rise in the government borrowing, leading to high fiscal deficit, high inflation. Theek hai? So agar fiscal deficit hoga to kya hoga? Inflation hoga. Then it affects the already low wages earned by the informal sector worker. So it leads to the vicious cycle. Then the policy initiatives fail to cover up the and regulate the informal sector, most of the initiatives. Lack of proper wages. So this is for the informal sector worker. Hum iski hum na pe baat kar rahe hain. Worker ke liye. What is the impact on the worker? So they don't have appropriate amount of wages. So if you see in the same company, for example, there is a big company. If there is a person called driver, if this driver is formally employed, this driver is getting approximately 50 to 60k on a per month, and the same job being done by the informal driver without having no contract, he will be doing maximum in 20k. So it will create the inequality among the driver itself. Low wages leading to the low saving and investment, because people don't have the affordability to spend or to save, leading to further reduced lending and disrupt the credit cycle. So agar saving and investment kam hoga, to banks, they don't have the proper deposit, which lead to the less lending by them. Informal sector worker, they don't enjoy the social security benefit like insurance, healthcare, education facilities, which impact the children, which impact the demographic dividend of the country. So you have to look from the economic perspective also, ki unke upar jo impact hota hai uska economic ka impact hota hai. Then there is a lack of loyalty, which leads to the low productivity, because there is high attrition rate. Koi job security nahi hai, koi incentive nahi hai, to kya hoga? People will be looking for new job. There is high attrition, and because of that there is a low productivity, and there is also the lack of financial literacy, which leads to the lack of institutional credit, reduces the consumption, slowing down the economic development. Apart from that, their working conditions are very, very poor. Then they don't have job security. For the women, they don't have maternity leave, leading to the women exploitation, gender discrimination. So the women are not given the employment because they will ask for the leave. Rise of slum, because they don't have the proper income. Poor standard of living, leading to the low human development indicators of India. And the concept of child labor, because of the poverty of the family, leading to the working of the child also. ठीक है, so child and woman exploitation, poor human development indicator, poor working condition, right? Inequality, low saving and investment rate, impact on the children, high attrition rate, low financial literacy. Now government initiatives to address the informal sector, there are various initiatives which have been taken long ago, starting from the Minimum Wages Act, then Child Labor Prohibition Act, motor transport workers, they'll be getting some minimum salary, they'll be getting the other facilities, Interstate Migrant Workmen Act, Employment Conditions of Service Act. So here say you can mention couple of act, for example you can mention Minimum Wages Act and the Child Labor Act. There are other benefits which are being given as of now, MG Narega, so that there is a minimum employment. Indira Gandhi National Old Age Pension Scheme, National Family Benefit Scheme, then Widow Pension Scheme, Catch for the Women, Ayushman Bharat, then Arogya Scheme, Atal Pension Yojana, then Pradhan Mantri Shram Yogi Mandhan Yojana for the pension, skill development, then Awas Affordable Housing, then Swachh Bharat, so that they have access to the proper sanitation, their health is properly maintained. Then policy on HIV AIDS, child labor, PM Mudra Yojana, Pradhan Mantri Jan Dhan Yojana for the financial inclusion, DBT, Ujjwala, Ujala, then code for the minimum wage and the working condition, that is the labor codes. Then Pandit Deen Dayal Upadhyay Shramev Jayate Yojana for the labor, again labor reforms, right? Pradhan Mantri Kaushal Vikas Swadesh, skilling of the migrant worker affected due to COVID pandemic. So ye COVID ke time pe aapke start hua hai. You can see there are other incentives which I have given in this slide, which I discussed for the employment, the labor law reforms, then this budget reforms for high investment and promotion of the labor intensive sector. ठीक है, and basically our focus should be that we should develop the labor intensive sector in the organized sector. ये हमारा focus होना चाहिए. So even all these, they should focus on creating the jobs in the organized sector. Now suggestions क्या हो सकते हैं? We can focus on the high technology area, because they can actually provide the high amount of formal employment. Public investment into the health, education, police, judiciary, again it will create formal jobs. Then combined school based learning with the work based, which we have just started in the new education policy 2020. Then other suggestions, these suggestions are from the Economic Survey 1920, that how to discourage the small companies, the dwarfs, incentivizing the infant farm rather than the small farm. ठीक है, so our focus should be to promote the young people rather than the old people, old companies which remain small. Sunset clause for all the incentive with some time frame. तो जितने भी MSME को हम लोग दे रहे हैं, for example we are providing third sector lending, they should be having some upper limit, that once you become 10 year old then you will get those benefit, so that they have the incentive to become big. Deregulating the labor law, for example in the Rajasthan is one of the model state where the labor laws have been reformed and really improved the status of labor industry. Reorienting priority sector lending by prioritizing the startup in high employment elastic sector. Then NITI Aayog has also suggested many things for the informal sector. Easing the industrial relations to increase the formalization, increasing the civilian's pay in line with the global best practices. Civilian's pay matlab, if you are terminating the informal employee, then the informal employee will get some minimum amount, so that there is discouragement to the company to from eliminating the or terminating the employee. Overhaul the labor dispute resolution system to ensure that labor disputes are resolved quickly, so that the companies do not companies don't show the assistant from becoming big. Strengthen labor court tribunal for timely dispute resolution and set a time frame for the dispute, different dispute. So this is about industrial relations. Then there is a labor code on industrial relations coming. Then wages ke liye national floor level minimum wage, expand minimum wages act 1948 to cover all the wages, enforce the payment of wages through check or other enabled payment for all, so that there is some record and the minimum wages is actually paid. For working conditions and social security, enter a comprehensive occupational health and safety legislation based on the risk assessment, employer employee cooperation, effective education and other remedies. Worker housing on sites, enhance occupation safety and health in the informal sector through capacity building and target programs. Ensure compulsory registration of all establishment to ensure better monitoring of occupational safety. Then there are some incentive by the government, for example Shop and Establishment Act, which was amended some time ago. Enhance the skills and apprenticeship through LMIS. Ensure wider use of apprenticeship. Labor law reforms, codification, simplify, make the compliance of working condition easy, and national policy for the domestic worker. Domestic worker is also part of the informal labor. Okay. Then from the economic survey, we can get some ideas. Okay. See, basically, I will keep highlighting so that आपको आदत पड़ जाए उसकी, ठीक है ना? These 10 idea you will not be able to use everywhere, but try to use one or two idea somewhere, कभी यहाँ पे, कभी कहीं पे, ठीक है? तो उससे आपका क्या होगा? ये आपका याद हो जाएगा. Best thing will be you make a note of these 10 idea or take a printout of this slide and paste in front of your study table. उससे आपको याद हो जाएगा ये, ठीक है? So from this, how can we give the suggestion? So we can focus on grassroots entrepreneurs. Okay. Then pro business policies which can increase the ease of doing business. Then remove anachronistic government intervention again, so that formal sector can grow. Job creation by assembling in India, ease of doing business, and also strengthening the banking sector. Okay. So you can see कि मतलब दिस 5-6 सजेशन वी कैन गिव फ्रॉम दिस स्लाइड ऑल्सो. एंड नाउ देयर इज अ वन स्मॉल टॉपिक दैट इज अ कैजुअलाइजेशन. ठीक है, सो यू कैन गेट द क्वेश्चन ऑन दिस टॉपिक ऑल्सो, व्हाट इज द मीनिंग ऑफ कैजुअलाइजेशन ऑफ द वर्कफोर्स. ठीक है, सो फॉर दैट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड वन स्मॉल थिंग फ्रॉम द लेटेस्ट इकोनॉमिक सर्वे. The latest economic survey has used this word, that is why this is important. Otherwise also ye aapko news mein mil jayega. Theek hai, so informalization is slightly different, theek hai, from the casualization. So first of all, economic survey 1920, NSO data classifies the workers on the basis of employment status into three categories. Teen category mein hota hai. So either they are self employed or they are hired. Theek hai, to mostly hum do category mein dekhte hain. एनी वर्कर विल बी इन टू कैटेगरी, आइदर या तो खुद से अपना काम कर रहा होगा या फिर वो कहीं पर दूसरी जगह वर्क कर रहा होगा. सो सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड इज वन कैटेगरी एंड हायर्ड आर इन टू फर्दर कैटेगरी, वन इज द रेगुलर वेज सैलरीड और अनदर इज द कैजुअल. ठीक है, तो बेसिकली इनफॉर्मल के अंदर, इनफॉर्मल इंक्लूड्स द सेल्फ एम्प्लॉयड प्लस द कैजुअल, एंड कैजुअल इज जस्ट कैजुअल डज नॉट इंक्लूड द informal this self-employed category. ठीक है, did you get the difference? Informal can include self-employed, but casual is different. Now why there is so much casualization? Casualization basically means daily wage worker primarily. मतलब कभी काम मिल गया कभी काम नहीं मिला, कभी पैसा मिला कभी पैसा नहीं मिला, ठीक है, दिस इज कैजुअलाइजेशन। व्हाई फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल देयर इज डिस्गाइज्ड अनएम्प्लॉयमेंट इन द एग्रीकल्चर, दे आर माइग्रेटिंग, देयर इज डिस्ट्रेस माइग्रेशन टू द अर्बन एरियाज इन सर्च ऑफ द नॉन फार्म एम्प्लॉयमेंट एंड वेयर दे गेट मोस्टली द कैजुअल वर्कर, फॉर एग्जाम्पल इन द रियल एस्टेट, ठीक है। Then there is rapid growth of the real estate sector in the urban area and engineering in the rural area, which are mostly providing the casual employment only. ठीक है, तो ये mostly casual employment ही provide करते हैं. Then informalization in general, it also leads to the casualization of the workforce. So these are the three primary areas. Now coming to the question. Question says informal sector being a employer of over 90% of the total workforce has become an inevitable part of the Indian economy. Discuss the reasons and the government initiatives. So body ke andar to reasons we have discussed so much, humne itne sare reasons discuss kar liye hain. Government initiatives, you can start from Minimum Wages Act, Child Labour Protection Act, and then various acts in the recent time. And then in the suggestions, you can mention the Niti Aayog recommendation or economic survey. Two points from here and two points from here. ठीक है. Introduction में you can give the meaning of informal sector or maybe some data about the informal sector. ठीक है, so this is how you can give the answer. Any doubt in this question, please ask.